Hello, I'm Peter Myers, the course developer, and I'm here to talk to you about the self-study kit. You can download a self-study kit, and it consists of the presentation content and 6 hands-on labs. Note that these labs are very similar to the demonstrations I present in this video course. Let me now share with you the lab scenario. The labs are based on the sales activities of a fictitious company named Talspin Toys. This company represents a specialist toy sales business that sells model airplanes and helicopters to global markets. It accumulates its data in an Azure SQL database, and it's interested to explore, discover, and share deeper insights from this data. So, in the labs, as an app developer, you'll have the opportunity to embed Power BI reports and the Q&A experience into a web app. There are, in fact, 6 labs. In the first lab, it's all about getting started. It'll guide you through the completion setup tasks to prepare for later labs. You will check that required software is installed or upgraded and portals can be accessed. And you'll also sign up for a trial Office 365 E3 tenant. That comes at no cost. In the second lab, you will start by creating a Power BI workspace. You will then publish a dataset and report, and then go ahead and create a new report in the Power BI service. That means you'll have 2 reports, which you will later embed into your web app. In the third lab, you'll create a security group, register an app, create an app client secret, and then add the app to the security group. Using the Power BI service and as the tenant admin, you'll enable the setting to allow service principals to use the Power BI APIs and then grant admin access to the members of the security group. Then in the fourth lab, you'll develop an ASP.NET Core MVC app in .NET 5 to embed your Power BI reports. In the fifth lab, you will use the Power BI client APIs to add client-side filtering and a context menu. Finally, in the sixth lab, you'll explore 2 data permission scenarios by creating a dynamic role and also developing a data-driven security design. To complete the labs, you'll need a Windows PC that's Windows 10 or later, and you'll also need the following software: Power BI Desktop, the latest version, Visual Studio Code with the latest update, .NET 5, and a supported web browser. We recommend Microsoft Edge. You'll be guided through the setup in the first lab. So how do you get access to this self-study kit? Well, you can download it from this URL, aka.ms/deviad-online-course. On the landing page for this course, you'll be provided with some simple setup instructions. Step 1, you'll download the self-study kit, which is a zip file. You'll then edit the file properties and unblock, and then extract the file contents to your file system. The lab documents will refer to this location as course folder. You'll also find the presentation is available as a PDF document. The presentation contains all of the course content, including many links to useful resource material. To improve accuracy and reduce typing, many labs involve copying and pasting from snippet files. When snippet files are available, please do not copy from the lab documents. The rich formatted text blocks often paste incorrectly into Visual Studio Code. And lastly, a tip. Avoid the temptation to just copy and paste. Please take the time to understand the intention of each snippet. I hope you enjoy working through the labs and find them to be educational and entertaining.